My name is Cass Futialo. I'm a creative genius. Well, I like to think I am. But I messed about here and there with the arts, as they say. Just what I do, and I think I do it good. My piece here is based on my village, Salimoa, and the piece is about my logo. And my logo, because I wasn't born in a hospital, I was born in one of the old traditional whaleo'u, and I was delivered by the local old lady, so I have that connection to the earth. I've been involved a few years back with Jim Viviari in the Bottle Ocean. It's a collection of island artists. I think I was the only one that didn't go to art school. That was the path that I was supposed to take with full-time then music. Music was sort of my weak point. But my love for art started when I was a kid in Samoa because most of my friends couldn't afford to go to the movies. But I was the one that had like 10 cents to go to karate films. Then I would come back home and tell them the story about how the film went from front to back. Then it got to a point where I had to draw it out for them. So it became a skill. I have that vision about a music video because when you write a song, you already picture the video to it. It's really helpful for an editor as well because it cuts down the guessing. I basically direct all my videos and like trying to do something that you enjoy but it hasn't been done before. Coming up is the English album that I'm working on. I've just finished the Samoan album and it came off quite, it did well. Picking up the best Pacific album in New Zealand, best language album. So you don't go and do it again. As for a creative person, it's like, you need to expand. London was amazing, the organizers, They found me on YouTube. Thank God for YouTube. They were looking for someone to represent the island of Samoa, and we performed at an old naval base in Greenwich in London. This is where Captain Cook got his orders to go out into the Pacific. It was like, wow, I am probably the first of my family to go to London where the Queen stays. So that was one of my missions, is to go and see the Queen. And I did. Oh, she just texted me and said, oh, someone's gonna come to the back door and let you guys in. Of the dime of life down to a jewelry box, now you know how. What makes a song, it's the chemistry or something that's different that you put together and it becomes something else, it becomes something powerful. If you're not finding any joy or fun in what you do, you should do something else. Yeah.
Dark boys high on the hill are dead as the bright leaves falling, walking their bikes up the dusty track, stopping to smoke and look at the ants, like lost stars set above the city. They pretend no one they love is buried there. When I meet other young Pacific girls, and they say, oh, I'm not brown enough, I'm not smart enough, I'm not pretty enough. They're never enough. That message of, actually, you got something that no one else does. I really feel like our people, and especially the next generation coming through, have a kind of edge above everyone else. My name is Courtney Sena Meredith, and I'm a poet, playwright, musician. Today is my first exhibition. So for the full 6 weeks, I'm going to be writing a new poem every day for the community of Mangere. I've been really influenced by my travels to Germany. I had 6 weeks working across different projects. I delivered a poem for the German president while I was there. I wrote new works every week. I've never been so out of my comfort zone. Some things are really hard for a Samoan girl, like having fittings for a French couture gown that was being made for me. I'm not used to going and standing around with eight other German girls and they just drop it. I wasn't raised like that. I think about this a lot, and I know that I was raised by so many people. I was raised by the city, but it was having a mother that chose me over the world. My mother had me when she was young. She could have been Prime Minister by now if she hadn't have had me, but she chose me. She chose me over everything else. And when I come across these other artists now, I say to them, what we're doing, it's a privilege. Don't have the right to turn away from it. I take the bones I used to be and I wash them in the Waikato. My grandmother sewed denim. My second father drove a truck.
From the Mount of Olives come promises. They are like gold flakes in a stream. They are like electric fences of the mind, keeping the cows brown.
My work exists for me. I'm really incredibly moved when anyone else finds it interesting or relatable, but I have created this work for me because I need that voice out there. I need a young, mixed heritage woman out there who can look back at my world and say, you're awesome as you are.
For me, it's about raising the question. If everyone could start sort of putting their hands up and raising questions, then I can see in the next 20 years it'll be a nicer place for our kids. I've always questioned my parents, I suppose. But if we came for a better life, if we still haven't found it, then why did we come in the first place? So my work is dot patterns of two words, tamawililangi and tangaloaalangi. Tangaloaalangi is our pre-Christian god. And then we've got the Māori-langi, our Father in Heaven. It works on the idea of playing with words. And for me, it's being at that scale, at that size, it's the same sense of walking into a church where that you get that sense of power. So for me, at that scale was a huge jump from, you know, a slogan on a T-shirt. I've always tried to put something out that people need to take a second look at, because it's having that initial chuckle, you know, and then having a bit of a laugh, but then I hope what leaves behind is a question. So I try and Trojan horse my message and plant the seed that way. This piece here is a dedication to my wife, my mother, my sister, my daughters. It's based off the malu that's on the back of the knee of the female tattoo. And for me, it's a tribute. It's a tribute to their role in my life. It's on my left hand because I know it's cliche, but it's closer to my heart. But it's also so that I never forget. You know, that expression that I know it like the back of my hand. But the boiler suit for me, it takes me back to uncles working in Fresh Nooks. And it's that message of building, you know, a better life for their kids and their families. So every time I put it on, it reminds me that we might be in a flash gallery, you know, and start, we might be, you know, making some money off our artwork, but never forget where you come from. It's now.